Good evening, guys. I have on my desk a box. I decided, as I hadn't been there for a while, I would have a look at the junk shop. And I've basically bought a box of junk.
Oh, yeah.
Yep. So, I've got a few other bits that I've got around town today. We'll get to those in a moment, but I don't even know what's in this box. I just saw through the side all these nuts and bolts and thought,
yeah,
that would be useful. So, I'll take the lid off and we'll see what we've got. Lots of rubbery, oh, I think I know what you do with those. Because here, I don't know if you can see that, it's one of those sort of kettle lead sockets there. Can you see that? And I'm guessing you can put this over it to make it a little bit watertight. There's another socket. There's even, where's the camera? There we go. There's even the plug ends as well. It's got these two, these sockets. Oh, and those ones in here. More plugs. I think that's virtually it for plugs and sockets. And these sort of rubber boot things that go over them. Oh, there's another one. The rest is literally just assorted nuts and bolts, which is what I really bought this for. There we go. Some brass nuts and some little grub screws. Well, I should say rather large grub screws. Bag of screws. And then I've got all that in the bottom. So that is it for this box. I'll chuckle this back in there and I will return it. Right, I'm back. Just had to take a quick potty break. Ooh, pardon me. Move this out of the way. Yep, I decided I'd set you up on the tripod by my desk today. Oh, I forgot a bit. When I was with my stepdad the other day, I should say, because this wasn't at Mum's, we went over to the old workshop first, and we finished tidying up the workshop. Actually, it's all been tidied up and made nice. It's just a bunch of stuff that's got to go down the tip, which we should be doing tomorrow, and that will be everything done and dusted. But I did find, lying on one of the shelves in the old workshop, another soldering iron. This one's a Hilke brand. Actually, it doesn't look like that tip has been used that much. But it looks like, you know, just a normal soldering iron tip will fit it. But this is a bit different. You clip it to a 12 volt battery. Or I suppose if you had a 12 volt supply, you could run it from a 12 volt adapter, but I'm guessing this is designed, you know, for perhaps an auto electrician, you know, so they're working under the hood of the car, they can just clip this on the battery and do a bit of soldering on the fly, as it were. But I'm sure I could make use of this. If not, I'm pretty certain this tip will fit in my Weller soldering iron. And I'm just going to move you a bit. I absolutely love that picture. I couldn't help it. I had to show you. I love that background picture. She, Octavia here, is one of my favourite ponies from the show. Right, Wales. Where Mum lives at the moment, you've got to walk down a very dark sort of alleyway to get to her back gate. we only use the back gate because, well, they sort of built these bungalows arse about face, really. Because the front faces the railway line, but the back faces the rest of the housing estate. And where the car parks, you have to walk down the little alleyway down the back to get in at the back gate. It's weird how that's all laid out, but there's no lighting down there. So I've bought these to put on Mum's wooden fence. They're little solar lights. They only cost £2 from a charity shop, box of four. And I've charged them up, I've checked them all. I don't think I'll use all four, but I will take all four just in case. They're not bright bright, but they should be enough, you know, to illuminate our way. And I actually like these, I think they look nice. It makes me laugh though, I've got that little bit of rubber there on the switch to waterproof it, but when I took these apart to take the battery out to charge it, because they run on one AAA 500 milliamp hour rechargeable battery, there's no rubber seal around this bit, it's just plastic screwed to plastic. So I'm just wondering, you know, why did they bother with that bit? I shouldn't think these would have cost a great deal brand new. They do feel kind of cheap and chintzy. But they should do the job. If not, they'll just look pretty. Right, Wales. So I haven't got to move too far yet. Zoom you out for this one, if I can remember which way to zoom. No, wrong way. Oh, you were zoomed out. Oh, weren't zoomed all the way. I got this month's My Little Pony magazine. And I'm a bit stuck between... Actually, I'm going to show this in a minute because I'm not going to get it on screen. But I've got a poster here and I'm not sure which side I want to have facing on display. I really only bought the magazine because I wanted... Whoops, I've got them all tangled up. Because I wanted the M3 key rings that came with it. So we've got Princess Cadence key ring. Hang back up here for now. Yeah. There's Princess Celestia. And of course... Surprised I didn't include a Princess Twilight, but never mind. The Princess Luna. I think out of all the princesses, I've got to say she's my favourite. Don't tell her, sister.
Yeah.
No, don't tell her, sister. Uncanny timing, that really is. What have I done? I've bought a new camera. Just got to wait for that to arrive in the mail. Thanks to a fellow brony, fellow YouTuber, who has helped me out. So, many thanks, Mark. If you want to check out his channel, it's Mark Hyder. H-Y-D-E-R. He's a brony like me and a vlogger. So, although his videos... What's a video? His videos are actually... in my opinion, better than mine, but he's got things like an intro and whatnot, which I don't have yet. Because I've, I don't know why, but lately I just feel like really getting into YouTube a bit more and putting more effort into it. So, I'm not going to buy a video editor yet. I don't remember putting that one in my screen folder. but what I'm going to use is Movie Maker. I don't know why Windows took the Windows off the title, because it's still the same thing, but never mind. Because you can actually do quite a lot with that. I remember using it in Windows XP, and it really was about as basic as you could get. I mean, well, compared to the editing suites you can buy, it is still basic, but it's come a long way since Windows XP. I really don't remember putting that in that folder. Right. Yes, I'm gonna. Actually, there's another item I'm gonna have to either move the camera for or just. No, actually, I'll just turn the camera around. I've bought some more squishy pops. My Little Pony squishy pops. I've actually got. I should have two in this area somewhere, which are duplicates. Which, of course. Oh, don't tell me I've thrown them in the bedroom with all the others. You dum-dum. Now I've got to go through them all and find them too. It's just a Fluttershy and a Pinkie Pie duplicate I've got. Gotta loosen that neck off a little bit. Do I go get some? Yeah, I'll go get some. Hang on a minute. Right. Yeah, I've got quite a few of those now. I've actually got 15 of the 25 now. And I want to complete the set. So I'm going to get on eBay at some point. I say eBay because, well, no doubt Sainsbury's will restock these. And, well, I suppose, unless I go into the city to find these, because Sainsbury's is the only place in town that sold these. But then I've got the risk of getting more duplicates. Wibbly wobbly wibbly. I can hear them wobbling around in there. I've got seven today. That's what was left in the box. Do you know what someone had done? You got the little cardboard box that these come in, right, on the shelf. And right in the front, there was a Starlight Glimmer figure sealed inside like a little plastic thing with a clear window, like, to demonstrate what the little squishy pops look like inside these. That had actually been stolen from the box. And there's one of these lying all ripped open and empty. Someone had actually stolen one out of these as well. Anyway, I've got another two of these Fashems as well. I've got Rainbow Dash. Here she is. Queen Chrysalis looks really seductive in that picture, doesn't she? Or stoned. She could be stoned. Or drunk on cider. I also have another Sweetie Belle. Anyone wants her for a couple of quid? Or to swap? I'm open for swaps. And I've got a couple of fellow bronies that watch my channel, so. I don't know. If you haven't got Sweetie Belle and you want to swap, and I've got Sweetie Belle there as a double. That's what I hate about buying blind. That's a good way to get you to spend money, isn't it? Because you don't know what you're going to get. But I only got lucky this time with Rainbow Dash. She can go through with Apple Bloom and Sweetie Belle. I believe there's only six of these to collect. 25 of these. Let's see if I could find the other ones. The ones I got today, nope. That's Fluttershy. I may actually store these boxes safely. Ah, here's one. I've got the crystallized Twilight Sparkle. What's this one? How about that? Two in a row. Two new ones in a row. Here we've got the Crystallize DJ Pwn 3 or Vinyl Scratch. Vinyl Scratch is an actual pony name. DJ Pwn 3 is a DJ name. That's the duplicate Fluttershy. So if you know anyone that's looking for one of these, I've got one. Again, I'll sell or swap. So I'm going to stand that up here. Ooh, I've got to take a thingy off this one. That's a crystallized Rainbow Dash. One of my favourites, Octavia. What's that? Got through five already. That's crystallised Fluttershy. I've even kept one of these, so I've got them ticked off, so I know which ones I've got without having to look in these boxes. Spiky Wikey. That's what Rarity calls him, Spiky Wikey. Right. Hey! Can't have Octavia without Vinyl Scratch. Vinyl Scratch was one I got today as well. Rarity is another one that I got today. What do you have to say? That is a good likeness. Why is it these are so small, but they're such an accurate likeness to the actual character? But yet you can get something bigger, like Lyra here, which isn't actually that accurate. Not head and face wise, anyway. Not in my opinion. Behave. What have we got? Oh yeah, this is another one I got today as well. Starlight Glimmer. Yeah, I did it. Get off. Pinkie Pie. I've got another one of these, so I'll put that one up on my shelf. Did I actually put the duplicate up here or not? Yes, I did. Because I put the paperwork back in it as well, so it is complete. It's got the little plastic ring on the bottom. Julie! It's not one I got today. What's this one? I think I got that one today. The crystallized Pinkie Pie. Derby's got herself all tangled up in some tape though. It's another one I don't remember putting in there. What is going on? Yeah, this is one I got today because this has got the damaged box. I think I've got. Speaking of Derpy, look. Derpy! Oh, they haven't printed the wonky eyes on her. Yeah, I did. That's one I got today as well, the crystallized Cheerilee. I think I got that one today. Or I might have got that one the other day. I can't remember. Yeah. And there's my duplicate Pinky. For trades, or for sale, whatever. I think. Not only do I have a vocal Rainbow Dash on the computer, I've got a vocal cat as well. Here we go. 15 of the 25 to collect. Right. Thank you. one more thing to show before I budge the camera. Cool, smells old in this carrier bag. Because I've got quite a few of these 45s. One of my favourite charity shops to go indoor, to go into, has had a load of these donated, so I went through the pile. You don't see these in charity shops that much these days. Well, I've got all sorts here. So. Gary's Gang, Keep On Dancing, I ain't got bloody clue, it just seemed interesting. George Michael, I just had to. Had to get a George Michael one. These are all 50p each. That's why I like to get these from charity shops, because they are cheaper, obviously, than if you went into a collectibles. What we got here? Billy Ocean, we got Suddenly by Billy Ocean. And Lucky Man. Some Phil Collins. Spandau Ballet. To cut a long story short. And what's got? It's on both sides, so. Well, it's got version written on the back here, but on side two, but what version? I don't even know what the condition of these is actually like. Ooh, they're not bad. I've got that song in my head now. Yeah, I've got quite a few on here, just went through and picked them all up. 50p each, I think I spent about £9 in total. Rock and Roll Disgrace. Oh, I've got the Sweet. So I've got some 70s sort of glam rock in this as well. I like a bit of everything. Modern, old, techno, even some orchestral stuff. I won't say classical, but I will say orchestral. Because it depends what it is. I'm not too keen on the sort of classical, but... if it's orchestral, like the London Symphony Orchestra or something, then I'll quite happily listen to it. I've actually got some on the PC. Roy Orbison, you got it. You're the only one. I've got quite a few here. Got some Slide. Core. I love that old smell. Ooh, I don't know what it is, but I just love that old sort of paper smell. Slade, Take Me Back Home. Lead singer, Noddy Holder. Oh, it looks like this one was sung by two people. There's another one in that. What the hell? Have I accidentally saved some pictures into that folder? It doesn't matter. Well, actually, yes, it does. I'm just going to check this folder. Just to make sure, no, not safe for work things have managed to find their way into here. Nope. Nope, that's good. Nothing naughty is going to show up on screen. I've seen a lot lately on pony groups on Facebook where people have asked, you know, I actually saw one person ask, is Brony and being a furry the same thing? And I'm both. I'm both a brony and a furry. Been a furry since 2006. Purely because... That's better. Purely because I just like always loved that sort of cartoon, you know? When I was growing up, I always watched Tom and Jerry, Bugs Bunny, Animaniacs, Tiny Toons, Super Ted. Actually, most of the cartoons I watched when I was growing up didn't have humans in it. It was always the talking animals. So I've always loved that sort of thing, which is what got me into furry in the first place. But I've actually noticed there seems to be a number of bronies that don't like furries. And I've not understood why, but if these bronies have come across furries which have lumped them in as being a furry as well as a brony just because they like My Little Pony, which, you know, is talking ponies. And actually, they've got quite a few human characteristics, like, well, as you saw a minute ago, Vinyl Scratch and Octavia on my screen. Octavia plays the cello and Vinyl Scratch is a DJ, so she's got her decks. So technically, My Little Pony is anthropomorphic in that sense. But I'm not going to call a brony a furry, because that would be like calling a fan of Pokemon a furry. Are fans of anime, they're otakus, aren't they? Otakus. But there's anime out there as well, which is anthropomorphic based.
Yeah.
Thank you, Rainbow Dash. But you don't hear anyone calling them furries, you know? If that's what some furries have done, you know, just stuck a label on bronies, and I'm not surprised that some bronies have developed, you know, a certain amount of dislike towards furries in the fandom, but they are similar. But to me, they're two separate fandoms. You know, one is strictly for those that love My Little Pony, and one is strictly for those that love everything anthropomorphic and animals. Excuse me. Rainbow Dash is vocal tonight. There is a sexual element in both fandoms, but to me, the way I see it, you know, your sexual fantasies are your fantasies and they should remain, you know, private and personal. Why some people feel the need to go online and broadcast it here and there is beyond me. You know, I don't talk about my fantasies on any Facebook group. Because to me, you know, what I'm into is, it's my personal business. But anyway, doesn't bother me, because I've always been the type of guy, you know, whatever floats your boat. Ah, two other things that I've actually almost forgot about before I end the video. I might have to move a bit more for this one. What can I get in?
Yeah.
And that's upside down, isn't it? But I've got this side of the poster. This is my first and only poster, by the way. So I've got the side with the main six on, which I actually have to say is the side I'm leaning towards putting on my wall. Or, I nearly got it upside down again. I've got the side with all four princesses on, so if you're watching this, Mark, which side? Which side would you put? I'm thinking main six. I mean, I could always swap it if I get bored. So I've got to go and get some sticky tack because I don't have any. I used to, but I don't know where it's gone. The other thing, yeah, is for my friend King Cone on YouTube. I got one of these.
Duh.
Pardon me. 1992, British Telecom, Petercombe, with a sleeve. And this is the second one I've got. I've got another one in my collection, which has got the date 1995 on it. But it's missing the sleeve here. And these are actually quite heavy. This one's quite heavy. And that, when I picked it up, was full of snails in the bottom. Full of snails, full of mud. So it's obviously been sitting where I found it for quite a long time. I mean, some people would probably see that as stealing them, but from who? It's just something that's been abandoned on the side of the road. That had been sitting there for months and months. In fact, I know it has. It's been sitting there since before Mum even moved from the village where I found this one. So, if it's stealing, who from? And that's such an old cone, you know, no, BT don't use those anymore. I just see it as clearing junk up from the side of the roads. Obviously, I wouldn't go into someone's garden or onto a private premises and steal them. That would be definitely stealing, but when it's just left, well, technically the cops could actually do you for theft by finding, they call it. Yeah, if you find something and take it, you can get done for theft. I think that's daft personally, but anywho, I do believe that might be it. Get this video up, get it edited. I did get a couple of PC games today for 50p each. One was Sonic 3D and the other one was Judge Dredd. I don't know why I keep buying them. I don't play the damn things. I just sit on my shelf in there looking pretty. But one day I'll play them. One day. Right. One thing in the bedroom, I've got another bicycle project as well. So, I've just realised I've got all the cables connected, so all I'm going to do is just stop for a minute, get you off the tripod, and right, here she is. I think we're zoomed in a bit. Why is the battery low? I've had the thing plugged in. Every time I turn it off, there must be like a default zoom setting there, because I have to zoom out every time I turn it back on. But here we go. There's another little shopper bike. It's actually a rally shopper. You can tell where they all got their name from, can't you? That's what. If you ever wonder why a bike like this is called a shopper, well, that's why. Regardless of make and brand. I'm going to give this a clean up. I was going to do a full restoration, but I think what I'm going to do is just leave it as it is. Obviously do the repairs I've got to do, like reattach the gear cable, because I had to take it off to get the wheel out to get it in the car. There's a couple of, for some reason there's a wheel nut missing on each wheel. I have no idea why. Grease up the steering column, or the steering tube bearings, whatever you want to call them. Because they're rather stiff. Just give it a clean down. Get rid of that stupid plastic tray. Sort the brakes out. Or at least sort the rear brake out. Because the cable's snapped. Put a rear brake block in. Like I said, give it a clean. Stick some lights on it. And, change the front tire. Because that is absolutely knackered. But it's just as well, I do have spares. And, it'd be another good one to ride around. Oh, and I've got to put a seat post and seat in it. The seat fell to bits, and the seat post, well, I think that was more rot than seat post, so I just before I bought it back from Mum's, because when I was at Mum's the other, when I was at Mum's the other day, and we were over at the old workshop where this was, I just took this straight from there to Mum's, put it in the garden temporarily because it was on the trailer, and we took the trailer and everything back, and then I threw it in the car. But there's a pile of crap to go down the dump at Mum's, so I just thought I'd take the seat post out while I was there and throw it on the junk pile. So this one's another project. These are actually pretty simple. But not many people restore these. I've never seen them restored. They always go for the old, what they used to call a sit-up-and-beg type bikes, you know, the full-size three-speed bikes, like the old Triumphs and whatnot, and the Phillips. And so, but I like to be different, and I personally do like these shopper bikes. There was no monetary value in this if I restored it. You know, I wouldn't get any extra cash for it, but it would only be restored because I'd want to, for the, you know, the fun of restoring it. This is my four. I've got four now. Four. Actually, I've always had four. It's just this one's been sitting in the workshop at the old house for I don't know how long. I was going to break it for parts, but when I got it here and I've got it in better light and actually given it a better look over, it's not actually that bad. The chrome on the handlebars is actually good. Or good for its age. Even this rear rack isn't that bad. Probably thanks to having this on it, which sort of shielded it a bit. Yeah, aside from some repairs, back tire. The tires hold air, but it's been sitting in the workshop for more than 6 months doing nothing, so they've just gone flat from sitting there. Actually, the front one's probably gone flat from a dodgy tire tube as well. This would actually be an absolute easy restoration. That back wheel's not actually too bad. Front wheel isn't worse rust-wise, but it's all surface, you know. There's no rot in the rims. There's no risk that the rims will collapse on me. Biggles, who gave me this originally, Mum's old neighbour from the old house, he has taken the badge off the front there, which doesn't matter because I've got rally badges I can stick on if I want. I'm not too fussed about that. But yeah, I think most of the dust has come from the workshop. I don't know what year the bike is. I will clean that rear wheel hub up. I can't find the finger. There we go. Because the three-speed hubs, they have a date on them. A manufacturing date, right? So I don't know how well this is actually coming up on the camera. So that would give me a ballpark year of when this bike was made. Because obviously it just depends how long Rally had the hubs sitting in stock as well. Because obviously, you know, they would order them from Sturmey Archer when they had their wheels built. But yeah, it would give a ballpark year anyway. So I think it's time. Me to shut the video down and get it uploaded to the PC. Stick it you back on the doodad, but leave this on charge as well, I think. So hopefully I can get you lined up. But yeah, it's actually quite easy to get this one lined up. It's not that easy to get your fingers in here to turn the hand screw. There we go. Ooh. Where's the end of my cable? My video cable, that is. Plug you back in. There we go. Right. I'm not going to plug external power in because it actually shuts you off to switch over to external power. So Focus. Thank you. Still not focused very well, is it? There we go. So, thanks a lot for watching. Hopefully, as soon as that camera arrives, I can't remember if I'm going to have to buy a new battery for it. Not an issue if I do, I'll just get that next time I get paid, so it's not a problem. Shouldn't be much longer before I'll be back to using digital cameras. It's just so much more convenient and easy and easier. This is more fun, but the digital camera is just so much easier. So yeah, thanks for watching. And don't forget, if you want to, comment, rate, subscribe, and all that lovely, wonderful stuff. These videos, I promise, they will get better, and eventually I will have an intro of some sort. I'm still running ideas in my head. Not sure how I'm going to implement those ideas yet, though. Don't you even think about it, but we'll just see. Still got a lot of the year left yet. Anyway, thanks for watching. He just stuck his claws right in my leg. I scared him earlier and I knew he would get his own back on me later today, and he just did. Didn't you? Anyway, thanks for watching, and I'll talk to you again soon. Bye. To be honest. Yeah, I'm not fond of my